Hey guys, Fry here, and welcome back to episode 6 now. I think it's episode 6, almost positive, of our Mortal Kombat 1 Invasion Mode Season 1 playthrough. And in today's episode, we're going to be playing as Rain with Sub-Zero's cameo. At the start of this episode, I correct what I said about in the previous episode about missing this area. So I just decided to start the area off right by where that is in order to just get right into it. Forgive the Rain gameplay. I had only really done like 2 Survivor Towers with him, and obviously labbed in, you know, practice mode and things like that. And I found that Sub-Zero has a very good, somewhat of a reset 50-50 case, but can also be used for just a bit of extra damage. Rain seems to very much be a zoner, but a slow zoner. And I feel like Sub-Zero complements him well by making him immune to projectiles, so he can zone you out. I know it sounds weird to think of a zoner character as not actually really being able to zone, but that's kind of how I feel he is. He does have some pretty cool combos, and you know, he is a lot of fun. I do drop a lot of combos, I think, just because, like I said, I haven't been playing him long. But we get a nice little uppercut from over there. And I love my skin for Rain. I also love the staff I have. I think it looks so cool. It's like a little skull dinosaur head, I think. At least that's what it looks like to me. But or a serpent, I think it's supposed to be, actually. But either way, I finished that off, used the key that I had wondered what the key was for ages, and unlocked this chest. Inside it is a homing magic orb talisman, a uncommon elder flask of rage, a Baraka pallet, and some Ashra gear. So it was definitely worth the trip and me realizing, I'm so glad I did, because at some point I do want to learn how to play Baraka, just not quite yet, however, so a bit iffy on that. But now I just basically go the way that we ended off last episode, where I was gonna start. Oops, sorry, I didn't mean to knock the mic. Where I was gonna start the tower. I think I check my talismans here, though. I'm not 100% sure. I'm like 90% sure. I really should be more sure, considering I edit them down so the loading times are a little less long. But I also check the relic out. Magic resistance increased and physical resistance decreased. So I don't meet the requirements of having 10 defense, but I check out the other talismans. So we have a fire orb talisman that shoots a fire orb towards your opponent. Basically the same as the flaming skull one, I guess. Then we got the summoner sentient magic orb that targets your opponent. And finally, pull a fire meteor down upon your opponent. I don't really like the meteor ones. I believe I do equip the new one we get. I'm not sure. That there I'm reading, yeah, summons a sentient orb, so it's like the same as the one before, but better, I think. I'm not 100% sure, but either way, we get right into the tower. The reason I'm not 100% sure is because I actually recorded this quite a while ago, and I'm only now getting around to commentating over it, because I have to make sure I upload and schedule all my videos before my hard drive completely dies and it gets swapped. I explained it in the last video, but, you know, helps to explain it again, I guess. But yeah, look at my staff. It's kind of like a serpent skull or something, like a Leviathan skull, I guess you could say. Even though, you know, they're like a mythical creature, that means they're combat. But I really like that Rain has an air bounce, because he's the first character I've played that actually has an air bounce. And it's pretty fun doing. I really enjoy just bouncing them, even though you can't really get that many hits after it. I still enjoy it. I think it's pretty cool. I have noticed, though, that he feels kind of slow, and although he does seem to have range, he doesn't actually have that much range. Most of his range buttons are pretty slow, which is what I noticed. He is overall seems very slow, is I suppose in my point. But fun. Really fun. I don't know how far I'm going to go as it comes. like goes forward towards learning him, or whether or not we're going to see any online gameplay, I'm not sure. But I might give it a whirl. Also, I really like his grab telling you explode into a pile of goo and bones. And his just brutality pose and like end pose is super fucking sick. Just look at that T-pose, boy. He was the original T-pose. But we just get currency and seasonal credits, so not too much of a reward. It's just a tower. So I think I do try and do brutals and fatals. But in the last episode, I messed them up on the towers. And in general, I just kept inputting them wrong. I love that it's Shaolin Lion. But yeah, I put the ice armor on, I think, by accident. But also just because Serena cameo plus Kung Lao's hat stops, you know, the threat. And will probably make the AI not want to throw a projectile for at least a little bit. I've noticed his overhead is very slow. So it is very, very much reactable, I feel. Rain seems like one of those characters where I feel like at the beginning, it sort of stage of Combat League, he's pretty good. But higher up, it's just a struggle, is how I feel it would be for him. But how to do the classic Sub-Zero spine rep, just because it's just, I don't know what it is. Oh, we got more credits and currency. I don't know what it is about it. I think it's because, like, it's one of the first fatalities I ever saw, was him just ripping their head off with their spine. And I just love that every game is, like, although it's the same thing, it's a little different. They always make it a tiny bit different, and I enjoy it. Always going to be one of my favorite classic characters. From one of my favorite characters. One of my favorite classic characters. So, you know, when it's not in a game and he's in it, it feels all like, where's his classic spawner? He needs it. You know? Kind of same how, like, Scorpion kind of, it feels weird when he doesn't have the Hellfire one. Just brings them. I love it when you uppercut them and their head lands that way, because it basically their head sniffing their own ass, and I just find that fucking hilarious because I'm childish as fuck. But we are coming to the end of the tower now, the last fight being Geras and Darius. I haven't actually tried Darius as a cameo. I've heard he's actually pretty good. I know he goes very, very well with Reiko. You can get, like, the command grab that is just normally, you know, for damage or an ender. You can turn it into, like, a 30% combo, or maybe more on hit. Probably have to use Bar to get, you know, higher damage, but I know with Darius, he basically gets his command grab to become a 3-1. Which is so cool. That's one of the reasons I really like the cameo system. It provides so much more variety and shifts up your gameplay a lot more than variation, like you ever did. I know that might sound a bit weird, but it's like you have your character, you have it, your base stuff. You don't have to chop and change your special moves. You just have to switch cameos to adjust to a different playstyle. And I've already started doing that, like in certain instances where people are up blocking my smokes forward 3-2, the overhead, you up block it and it basically makes it completely unsafe and punishable and you are fucked. I will use Striker and start using the low. If it's a character that can try and like zone me more, I'll either switch to Sub-Zero to negate it, or if it's a character that can kind of zone but not amazingly, I will somewhat use Serena as more of a zoning tool with the forward straight dagger throw. And obviously just the combo damage she gets. And the fact that I figured out I can use the meter drain quite well when I get the basically like the command grab ender combo thing. And drain quite a bit of meter, especially when it's in the corner. It's very, very good, it would seem. Also, we got a lot here. We got a component. We got a shader for Rain, which looks sick. I think we get a Brutal, yes, down the drain. Which I, by the look of it and sound of it, I thought it was going to be something completely different to what I actually ended up getting. So I was a bit confused by that. But we do level up. Also, I forgot to mention, I leveled up Rain's like stats off screen when I first just changed it to him. Also, we use Madame Bo's key here in order to open up the gate. I think this is the last two, maybe three fights of this area, it would seem, because there is a portal. But this one is just one of those survive ones. It's a little different to the other one. It was like, well, you'll see right now. It's like they shoot these like little dot things shoot down, and basically there's a gap somewhere, and you've got to find it. And then they go across like that. And I found them quite hard to dodge towards the lower end. But this bit, I didn't really seem to have too much of a problem with. It was just mainly these projectiles going across the screen like that. But I mean, we passed it no problem. It wasn't exactly difficult. It doesn't do huge damage. I feel like you'd have to get hit by almost every single one for that to happen. But we get a Chaos Orb component and some seasonal currency as well. Getting a lot of components and talismans. And I don't want to sit there and go through them all on recording, because then you guys are just sat there watching me read what it says. You know?
Countless lives have been lost to combat.
Oh, I forgot this happens.
Their souls condemned to its nether realm. Scorpion commands this army of the dead. They are here to unleash hell.
I don't know why, but I found that so cool. But yeah, I think this is our first official big boss, like the end boss of an area fight, if you don't count the tutorial areas during the cage. But first, before I go in, I decided to spend the points. As you can see, I mainly spent most of them on special and agility, because he has 50-50s and a lot of zoning and damage that in combos comes from special moves. And I obviously added some to attack and defense and HP a little, but not too much. I mainly focused on special and agility for the overhead lows and the zoning damage, special cancel damage, because I just think that works better for him, at least in the way this layout format is. But I didn't expect her to have very many health bars. Like, I thought, well, the mini boss type person had two life bars. I think she has three, so basically I have to beat her three times. I don't know if I get my health back every time I beat her. Let's see. No, I don't. So you basically have one health bar and she has three. Although I think I do have more HP. Although that might just be because of the level up system. But either way, she doesn't have 100%. She has 94%, which is technically 100% per her, but as how it is, it's not. I don't know. But I believe every time we defeat her, she gets a different buff. I think the one that she has currently might make her slower when we're near her. I just can't really remember. But here I was checking the boots. I thought, oh, I'm going to finish her this round. I've already beaten once, but as you will see, I was wrong. Because I check the Brule again to make sure, and it ends up not being the moment. See? Just made myself look like a fool. God, I love the palette and staff that I have. It just looks awesome. But I don't know what the hell happened here. I was like, wait, what's going on? And then all of a sudden, this started happening again. And I was like, oh. Okay, so I guess this is part of the boss fight. To kind of drain my health more. To make the boss do more damage. But I feel like that would have been maybe best served doing it at the start of every one of the rounds. Or at the start of the fight. The first one. You know, I don't know. Either way, I feel like they're going to get harder the further we go anyway. But here she has armor. I recognized it from when I had the armor. Also, I accidentally killed. I think I do struggle a little bit while she has this armor to really do anything and stuff. Also, I'm trying to remember things and I'm a little panicked because, like I said, I haven't really played much Rain. So I was just like, oh my god, I'm fucking this up. I'm not doing cool combos and etc. But I feel like ultimately I did all right. Hopefully the next time I do record Invasion, it will also be with Rain again. Because unfortunately I didn't have a chance to record another Invasion mode after this, because my auto-life is basically deciding, I'm gonna crash if you try and do anything in the game. So, yeah, that's why we're fixing it now. But we get to see the Brutal. I think it looks sick. I love just how, like, smashes them flying. But it was not what I was expecting from the description and the picture when we first got it. So, it was a bit weird. But we get another legendary talisman, the Flesh Renderer, and then another consumable that's an enchanted booster. Outworld Eternal Flame Skin for Katana, some legendary fan gear for Katana that looks sick, and a shitload of fucking seasonal credits and other things. And we also find a secret fight. I don't know if you always get that at the end of this fight, or if I did something that made this happen. But either way, I was like, ah, cool. So the final boss wasn't three fights, it was four, technically. But of course, we fought Katana, so the secret fight had to be Melina. Right there, I'm not used to, like, I've got to get used to doing that back special when I see it, that move combo string hit, but before it, like, bounces them up a bit, because then it basically makes it impossible to get the air combo. So I need to get better at doing that. But I land that right there. I'm not even sure if I actually need me for that. I feel like surely I did. Yeah, I'm not 100% at all. Ah, here, the game freezes. I left it in like this to show you that it froze and then unfroze. In reality, that was like a minute and a half. I was like, I'm just going to wait. Because I didn't want to have to scrap a recording or cut it short because of that. But we decide to finish the secret fight off with that. Especially because, as well, it was a secret fight. And I was like, no, my luck. I'll come off, have to do it again, and I won't get the secret fight. But, as you can see, we managed to overcome it. And we get another talisman, another Dark Meteor talisman. So we're getting a lot of talismans, like I said. And once we finish that, that is when I realized, ah, okay, we are at the end of this area. So that is the end of today's episode. I hope you guys did enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.